expressions are formed by the combination of constants and variables. So here we have some examples and we have to write down how are these expressions formed. So here you can see that in the first expression we have y plus 5. This is formed when 5 is added to y. So we'll write over here 5 added to y. For the next expression we have 10a. Now this means how is this formed? This would have been formed by multiplying a with 10. So we write over here a multiplied by 10. Next is x upon 3. Now this would have been formed when x was divided with 3. So we write over here x divided by 3. Now this is how we can write down for any expression. Now another expression is 3x plus 2. This is formed when the first step would have been that the x variable was multiplied with 3 and to the product we would have added 2. Right, that only then this would have been formed. So we write over here, first of all, the first step of the question here would be 3 multiplied with x, and after that we will write, or you can just write and then and continue with the next step. So here I am writing 3 multiplied with x, and then the next step would be adding 2 to it. Right, this is how we write down the expression in detailed form. Now the question could be in the reverse format, and the reverse format would be you would be given the question like this and you have to form the expressions. So for forming expressions, let us do the first one. Here we have m multiplied by minus 9. So this would give us minus 9m. Next is 12 subtracted from z. So here we would have z minus 12. Third is y multiplied by 10 and then 7 added to the product. So here we do 10 multiplied with y, or here as it says y multiplied with 10, both mean the same thing, and to this we would add 7 like this. The last one is p multiplied by 16, that will give us 16p. So this was about the expressions, writing them in detailed form and writing the expression from the detailed form. Now the next we have using expressions practically. Now you would be given some situations like these. You will be supposed to answer the statements. Now here the first situation is that Sarita has 10 more marbles than Amina. We have to tell that how many marbles does Sarita have. For that we have to assume the variables. Now here I am assuming that let Amina have x marbles. Now according to this, if Amina has x marbles and Sarita has 10 more marbles than Amina, this means Sarita would have x plus 10, right? See, Amina had x marbles and 10 more than x would be x plus 10. So Sarita had x plus 10 marbles. The next situation is Balu is 3 years younger than Raju, and we have to tell the Balu's age. For this we would assume the Raju's age to be x years, and here we would have Balu's age would be 3 years younger. Now 3 years younger means if the Raju's age is x, as we have assumed, 3 years younger would mean minus 3, right? And that would give Balu's age. Next is, how old will Susan be 5 years from now? If I ask you, say currently you are say 10 or 12 years old. If you are 10 years old and I ask you how old will you be after 5 years? So you would tell me that you would definitely be 15. How did you do that? You added 5 to your present age. So we would assume Susan's present age to be y years, and 5 years from now means she would be 5y, right? That means y plus 5 will give her age after 5 years. Next is Vikas is twice as old as Raju. So we would assume Raju's age to be x years, and twice as old as him means 2 times the Raju's age, that is 2x. So Vikas' age would be 2x years. The last is that price of oil per liter is 5 times the price of rice per kg. So we assume the price of rice per kg to be rupees P. Now the price of oil per liter is 5 times this price. So if the rice per kg is rupees P, 5 times rupees P would give us rupees 5P. So we can even use the variables for practical situations like these.